babes. Hello, hello, hello. So today's video is a little different. I was asked to look into Kylie Rondy. So I didn't know who that was. I found this. It came up in my search when I put her name in. And I'm only a minute and 44 seconds. This is the first video I'm listening to. I did get like a little breakdown from a babe in a comment. But I have no idea what's going on other than that. She's missing from a party, and I believe this is her boyfriend because I've watched a minute and 44 seconds of this, and I started jotting things down, and then I started channeling, and that's never a good sign, number one. But I want to go over this with you, so I'm going to start from the very beginning, although it kind of starts like here-ish, okay? That's a minute and 13 seconds, but something was said, and it was a red flag immediately for me in the very beginning of this interview. So let me make sure the volume is up. I'm going to turn the baby's volume down just a bit. If it works. Hold on. There you go. Be careful. All right, here we go.
Feels that she's safe. So that's why we came here today, because I wanted to look around for myself because I haven't been here yet.
Pause. 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 Okay, that was a huge red flag for me. And why? Because, okay, first of all, I feel that she's safe. That's manipulation. Okay, and I'll get back to that. And then he says,
so that's why we came here today, because I wanted to look.
We came here today, and she looks down and to the side, and so does he. I think that these two are messing around together, okay?
Here we go. Myself, because I haven't been here yet.
Because I haven't been here yet. Displacement. Displacement. So if I was to manipulate you, right? And you say, my child's missing, and I think you did it. You know, you think this in your head. You don't say this. But let's just say I killed somebody and you think I did it. The first thing I would say as a manipulator would be, oh, I think she's perfectly fine, though. So when you find her dead, you're like, well, they thought she was fine, so they don't have nothing to do with it. Do you understand? You following me? And then the displacement. I wasn't here. I haven't been here yet. Displacement. Displacement. So that was big to me when I first heard the first 6 seconds. Are you kidding me?
It is an interview you will only see here on Fox 40 News. The boyfriend of missing teen Kylie wrote Westfall has heard from her. He says they exchanged text messages before she left for a senior farewell party at the Prosser family campground, the last place anyone so far has reported seeing her.
So he's trying to claim, as her boyfriend, she texted him to let him know she's going to a party. If I'm going to a party, I need to call my man. I need to call him. I need to let him know what I'm doing, where I'm going, how it's going to be, you know, everything. I ain't trying to text my man, I'm going to a party. He'd be calling me in 2 seconds, like, which party? Which party? What's the address? Hello? Not that I party, I don't do that shit. But still, this is why. This is why I've seen a lot of shit in my life. Whew. Here we go.
So I was just like, okay, be safe. Don't, like, do anything stupid.
He says.
Pause. Pause. I get the exact opposite of what he just said. You're not going to be safe. And you're being stupid. I feel there was an argument about this. About her telling him, I'm going to a party. I feel like there was an argument. Keep going.
Complained.
I haven't seen. This is where I've seen up to. I think a few more seconds, that's all I've seen. I don't know where this is going.
That is day, and she listened.
At 10:30, she responded to what I was saying and just said, oh, I'm sorry that you're going through that. And that was the last I heard from her.
Kylie's close friend.
I'm sorry that you're going through that? What? An enraged bit? I'm sorry that you're screaming and yelling and you feel this way? Because you don't think I'm gonna be faithful or whatnot. You understand? That's weird. That's weird. That's not right. Look at her the whole time just looking down.
And Kate
Cuno says they spent the afternoon together on Friday, just out.
Saw how they're holding their hands? That was... I don't know. I can't rewind. It's not letting me rewind.
They spent the afternoon.
We're just sweet, innocent children. Just sweet, innocent children doing nothing wrong. I feel like they did something wrong. I definitely feel like they did something wrong.
Afternoon together on Friday, just hours before she disappeared.
What?
The day of the...
What?
Afternoon together on Friday, just hours before she disappeared.
On into what I was saying and just sorry. Said, oh, I'm sorry that you're going through that. And that was the last time I heard from her.
Kylie's close friend, Kate Cuno, says they spent the afternoon together on Friday, just hours before she disappeared.
Okay.
The day of the party, I hung out with her. We made creme brulee.
So you was chilling with her before the party. Why wouldn't she go with her to the party? Did she go?
I mean, everything's normal. I don't think she ran away or anything. I mean, I would have noticed if something was slightly off.
While law enforcement, including the FBI, continue their search in and around the Prosser campground and reservoir, Jagger, Kate, and another friend went to Reno to search for themselves for Kylie. Only Fox 40 News was invited to go along. Kate says they were in Reno the day before the party, and Reno is a place Jagger and Kylie could go.
Wait a minute. So these two friends hooked up and went out to Reno and said, hey, come along. Wasn't she in the woods? She wasn't in Reno. She was in the woods at a party. What's she gonna do at Reno? What the hell is happening here?
Oh, for some alone time. We followed them to a location in the hills where Jagger and Kylie spent some time.
I hear the opposite direction. So wherever they took this news crew, it's the opposite direction. Keep going.
In the past.
I definitely feel like that in this current situation that she's safe. I don't know where she is. We don't have anything to go off of at this point, but I fully believe that she's alive and well, and I fully believe.
Alive and well? What do you mean? She could have drove off a freaking cliff for all I know. How do you know she's alive and well and safe? These are very specific words. He's intelligent. This kid is intelligent, just so you know. Like, he's articulate. Oh, we.
Believe that. The two of us, three of us, or other people are going to bring her home safe.
The two of us. Ooh, wait, the three of us. All somebody's going to do it. as he looks
now,
down,
Jagger,
did you see his looks? He don't even believe himself. Look. Come on, no, I'm sorry. It's the nails, guys. I try to look cute for you. Ugh. Really. Hold on, I'm sorry. Watch his eyes.
Two of us, three of us, or other people are going to bring her home safe.
Now, he's in a dead stare, a gaze. He's looking like he's not even looking at the woman. He glanced at her, but he's like he don't even believe his own. I'm reading this shit. This
Jagger
is crazy.
Again, would
I know
like
you saw it
to come forward. Who were
all right?